Hello and welcome to a very quick tutorial on creating a photo in photo effect kind of thing. Somebody had asked for this on the official Corel forums, and it's a pretty simple effect, so I'm going to show you how to do that. First, grab your rectangle marquee tool, make sure the selection type is rectangle, feather is zero. Go ahead and just select the area you want. Now, if you made a mistake or it's not quite where you want it, but it's the right size, with the selection tool or the move tool, either one, you can go ahead and right-click and just drag the selection around. This won't copy anything, this won't move anything, it's just there. Go ahead and go up to the selections menu and select Promote Selection to Layer. This is sort of like a copy and paste in place thing. It's pretty nice. With the selection still on, make sure you have your promoted selection layer selected. Go up to Selections, Modify, Select Selection Borders. What this will do is this will create a little box-like effect with the selection. Make sure you've got it going to the inside and select the border width that you like. Since this is a small image, I'm going to go ahead and select 10 pixels. Hit OK, go to Adjust, Hue Saturation Lightness. I do this for very quick, just jump up the lightness and it easily turns it to a white. You can also use the Paint Bucket tool, paint it in yourself using the paintbrush. You know, it doesn't matter what method you use. Go ahead and hit Selections equals None. Grab your background layer, go to Adjust, Hue Saturation Lightness, reset these settings, drag the saturation down to zero so it's got a nice black and white effect. The other option is to go up to your effects, photo effects, black and white film, have it suggest a color for you so that it's got the proper tones everywhere. You can then adjust clarify and brightness, give you some nice little grainy effects and so on and so forth. Final thing to do is add drop shadow. You can go to your layer styles, turn on drop shadow from here, and then just adjust these little settings. There we go. That looks good. Hit OK. The fun part about layer styles is that you can adjust them later. They're not permanent. But if you don't want to use the layer styles, which is understandable because it does take some rendering time each time, you can just go up to Effects, 3D Effects, go to Drop Shadow, and you know, essentially get the exact same thing. You have a few more options, but not many more. And you can even put the shadow on its own layer, should you choose to do so. Go ahead, hit OK, and you've got your final effect. It's that simple.